Today, as Dr. Jill mentioned yesterday, we will be discussing an English in a Minute episode recently that recently appeared on our website. And that is to take someone under your wing. And this idiom has is related to birds. And so we will be teaching a couple other bird-connected expressions today. So we'll watch the video first, yeah. And then
how's that look?
Oh, sorry. Welcome to English in a Minute. Some animals, like birds and insects, have wings. Sadly, humans do not. Thanks, Anna.
Yeah. Hey, Jonathan, how's the new coffee business going?
Oh, it's going great. Your cousin Keith has been a huge help.
I'm so glad he's taken you under his wing. You know, in our family, we call him Keith the Coffee King.
Well, he sure is the Coffee King.
If you take someone under your wing, you help and guide them. You make sure they have what they need. You are a little like their protector. You might do this for someone who is new to a job or school, or for someone who is new to a profession that you have experience with. And that's English in a Minute. So as we were saying, today we will be discussing this idiom a little bit more and as also discussing some other bird-related expressions. So if you joined us on Friday, was it, Dr. Jill? Mm-hmm. We were talking about some different skills and activities that we have been learning or doing during this stay-at-home period. I think the next slide is a photo of a bird I drew.
Oh,
so I put good. This up there to make Dr. Jill happy because she likes this kind of bird. Yeah, so
this is a tufted titmouse.
Yes,
and it has this very distinctive peak on its head.
And I have been learning. I've been learning a lot about birds. Dr. Jill knows a lot about birds already, but through this strange new activity I have developed, I learn about them while I draw them. So,
and you know, do you find that birds are relatively easy to draw compared
yeah.
to people? Say.
Kind of. I'd never drawn a bird before. And I have been trying to draw humans, like friends I know, their faces. It's very hard. Birds, mm-hmm. kind of easy.
Yeah, you've just got this one big black dot for the eye.
Yes. The eyes are a little simpler than trying to capture a human's eye, for sure.
Yeah.
So anyway, this kind of led us to create today's lesson, bird idioms.
Okay.
Let's
talk about some new words.
So these might be simple to a lot of you guys. You're a lot of really high level English learners, but they are not in our VOA Learning English word book. So I put them up here. So the first one is. Sorry, someone's saying that we are muted, but I think they meant, okay.
Muted, yeah.
Okay, yeah. So wing is the what you saw me wearing, the part of an animal's body that is used for flying. A duck is any one of many different kinds of birds that swim as well as can fly. Mm-hmm.
Yep. And everyone, I think, knows Donald Duck.
Oh, yes, Donald Duck, for sure.
Right.
And a nest is the place that birds build out of sticks and other pieces of earth where they lay their eggs and take care of their young when they hatch.
Yeah.
So these words will come up in our expressions today. And Sandow says, the early bird gets the worm. That is not one we will be teaching today, but we can talk about it anyway.
It's a bird idiom.
It is a bird idiom. There are a lot, so I just chose a few that are pretty common. But that one's common as well.
Shall we go to the next slide?
Sure. So as you watched in the video, if you were with us then, so to take someone under your wing means to offer them guidance or protection. And if you can imagine like a mother bird sheltering or protecting her young from cold weather, wind, or anything, that's kind of what it means. That's where this expression comes from. So you can use it in that way, like protecting someone from something dangerous or difficult. You can also use it as a, like you are guiding them through something that you have been through, maybe. It's also used, as we saw in the video, in kind of a professional way as well. In this case, we can describe this as a kind of mentor or a mentorship. A mentor is someone who helps someone else who is less experienced and usually younger than them. So yeah, we have a question for our participants. Mm-hmm. And that is, tell us about a time you took someone under your wing, or if you are younger, or if you have a different kind of experience, tell us about a time someone took you under their wing. And if you have questions about how to use this phrase, ask in the chat box before. Did we already mention the hands up?
You could always mention again for people who've just joined us.
Will you describe it a little more clearly than mm-hmm. me?
So in the participants box, if you click on that at the bottom, you should be able to see a button that says raise hand, and that will put your hand up. Okay, I see one hand raise. Conwin. Tell you what, let's do the gallery view. Oh, Maria has her hand up. Hello, yes. Maria.
Morning.
Morning.
About the question, I think like a mother, I take my children under my wing.
So you took your children under your wing. Yeah.
Yes. I think all parents take our children under our wing. Mm-hmm.
In the ideal cases, yes.
Yes.
Yes. It's the ideal. Yeah.
I think so. And when something need our guidance about a thing, we take the person under our wing. But I think that like parents, all parents in general, take their children under their wing. Mm-hmm.
And I think that's true of birds too, right?
For sure.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. So I think the reason that we developed this idiom is from watching bird parents
teachers take their students under their wing as well.
Students, yes, I think so.
Guiding them through, yeah, for sure. Good teachers. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Maria.
Shall we try Qua again?
Okay, yeah.
Qua had the cute puppy yesterday, right?
Hello, teacher. Hello, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. I want to tell you about my story. My math teacher, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Your math teacher?
Yes. Uh-huh. 1 year ago, I am very hate English. My English skill very bad, and I really really hate it. I cannot speak or I cannot listen any anything in English. When I see my teacher talk to me and give me some app. Like memorize Duolingo, he taught me should learn English, learning English very helpful for me. And then I'm learning, and he's a person give me the call, and and I am study in here by he helped me.
Uh-huh. So your teacher guided you through, took you under his wing, and now you are every day improving your English.
Yes. One year ago, I cannot speak. But now I can speak a little.
Only 1 year? Yes. That's very impressive.
Yeah, but it's very bad. My English is very bad.
Mm. No, we understand it.
Oh, it's great.
You told really? A whole story. Yeah.
Yeah.
So you said you use Duolingo for memorizing?
Yes. Mm. I'm studying in Duolingo and memorize. Mm-hmm. Beside that, I learning in a Khan Academy.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And watch a video in the YouTube, like TikTok.
Oh yes, TikTok.
Although I don't understand so much. I don't understand.
But, yeah.
Yes, I'm learning every day.
Every day, yeah, that's all. Yeah, just learn a little bit every day and you will see improvements after 1 year. That's very impressive.
Good work.
Good work. Yes. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi.
Tell your dog hi.
Yeah. Oh, my dog is here.
They're sleeping. Right?
Hello.
Hello.
Looks so sleepy.
She's sleepy. Yeah, huh? she's sleepy. Very lazy.
Same.
Good. Bye.
Bye. Thank you.
Okay, let's see. We have let's hear from Ahmed. Hello. Hi, Ahmed.
Ahmed.
Ahmed, how are you?
Hi, how are you?
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Where are you?
Fine. I want to talk about my line manager to guide me to take me under wings, mm-hmm. to improve my work and achieve my targets in work.
Mm-hmm.
And he helps me every day to improve my work. And instructs me daily with tasks,
mm-hmm.
to achieve our targets. And I try to helps our workers to achieve his work.
So you are trying to take other people under your wing also?
Yes. Oh. Yes. As my line manager do his duties to take me under wings,
mm-hmm.
I'll try to do this things to our works another.
Yeah.
Works.
Yeah, that's good. It's when you get guidance or help from a mentor, you can also find your own mentee or someone that you mentor passes through. And what do you do?
I work as an engineer, civil engineer.
Okay. And we did not ask, where are you calling from? I mean, which
from
country
Egypt.
Or city?
From Egypt.
Egypt, okay.
Well, and the kids are home, right?
Yes. Yeah. Because of coronavirus, we work from home.
Yep.
Well, I hope you're enjoying spending time with them.
Thanks.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you.
Talk to you later. All right. Let's see. We have Ibrahim with us. Let's hear from Ibrahim. So Ahmed pointed out something that's, I think, common, that I think an expression might be to pay it forward. Someone does a favor for us, we do a favor for another person. And that often happens, I think, if you are at a job and when you begin, someone takes you under their wing. And when another new person comes, then you have that opportunity to take them under your wing.
Yeah.
Let's see, where's Ibrahim? Ibrahim, are you in Ethiopia? Okay, hi.
Yeah. Hi, Dr. Jill and Ashley Thompson.
Hello. How are you?
Yeah, good, and you?
We are doing well, thanks.
Great.
Thanks for joining us again.
Thanks. I think as it was nicely explained by Ahmed from Egypt, it's quite common just to take someone under, you know, if you're just taken under the wing of your either someone else, you have to reciprocate that.
Mm-hmm.
Also take someone under the wing. And I remember that while I was here, I've been taken under the wing of my siblings and elders. And to be honest with you, I have not been their continuous support here today. And I've been successful. You know, I have just taken so many people under my wing, so many meetings at this time that I'm just offering a lot of psychosocial support. So it is quite common, and the other thing is like why we are just taking someone under the wing. There's like a school of thought, because I've been taught a psychology course. There is like kind of intrinsic motivation that you are just motivated. It's a kind of sense of purpose that it's an intrinsic responsibility that you should take someone under the wing, because that gives you an ultimate intrinsic satisfaction. So that's actually that kind of, because why birds are really motivated to take you know their kids,
sorry, what word?
What do you call the small birds?
A small bird, baby bird.
Yeah, the baby bird. You
chicks.
Know,
it's because, chicks.
Yeah, the chicks. It's because, you know, who told that bird just to protect that chicks? Because that's biology.
Yeah.
That's intrinsic. Because we are biologically motivated just to take some under protection. And that's why this is actually kind of reciprocate. We have to reciprocate.
Yeah.
So the biologist would say that you have a motivation, or the bird has a motivation to
protect
their young, to promote the survival of their species, right?
Totally.
But
that's one of the school of thought.
But there's, as a human, maybe your motivation is to make things work better in your environment, right? To, for example, at work, to make everything function smoothly. It helps if you can take someone under their wing and teach them the job.
And you, and also it brings you in your own satisfaction to help someone.
Yeah, and that's what you meant, your intrinsic motivation. So a good feeling that you have of that reward of from helping someone.
Yeah, totally. We humans are, you know, a social animal, and we're just living in an open system, you know?
Yeah.
Because in order to better function that system, you know, one system, if one system operates nicely, the other systems, you know, operating nicely. If one system, you know, doesn't operate in a very good way, it affects the other way, you know? Like, for instance, you can take climate change. If the amount thousand foresters are, you know, set into fire, we are directly or indirectly affected by, you know, climate change, because we are just living in our own system. That's why if I'm not, you know, helping, you know, my siblings and people or colleagues, you know, as we are just working together in a system, that really affects my life. That really affects the bigger picture. So we have to make sure that each and every system, you know, works nicely, so that we are just supporting each other.
Yeah. Ibrahim, you have a mic on your, are you using this mic?
Yeah, this is...
I think it's when it gets under your beard, it's hard to hear you. When someone in the chat said Ibrahim's voice is not clear, so...
But, yeah, no, we just want to hear every word you have to say, but it's very wise.
I think, yes, very profound thoughts this morning for us. I think that let me rephrase what I think that you were saying just now was that because of the coronavirus.
Oh, I think he was saying climate change.
Oh, was it climate?
Climate change. Yeah.
Okay, climate change. It's in our best interest to work together with others, right? To protect our environment or protect the earth for our own survival too, right?
Yeah. That means definitely, totally. I'm successful because you are. So, we have to support one another just to be successful. You know, being successful alone, it doesn't take me nowhere. Just take me nowhere. So we have to be successful together in order to celebrate. That's why we have to support one another. Like for instance, you know, those well-to-do countries are supporting resource constrained countries, and the other,
like South Sudan,
Ethiopia. Like for instance, Ethiopia is just receiving huge donation from the United States and from Europe, and other, you know, countries, because, you know, supporting Ethiopia, supporting, you know, the United States is supporting on top of, you know, the satisfaction on the top of humanity. It's really good. Like for instance, the United States is investing huge investment for the global health. That means, you know, protecting or slowing down diseases in some other country is slowing down diseases in the United States, because we are just traveling, you know, getting there. So it's better just to protect diseases before it is just coming to your country. Like for instance, had it been, you know, that, like for instance, coronavirus is like impacting us hugely. It's devastating the economy, right? Mm-hmm. But if we had, you know, protected the coronavirus from its origin in China, we had not been, you know, suffered. We had not been locked down here right now, right? So it's really good just to support one another.
Right. I think that's a huge lesson we can take from this entire situation right now, is that we're all in this together and we all must support one another. Mm-hmm. We aren't islands.
Thank you, Ibrahim.
Thank you.
We have a couple, well, we have a new hand raised. Eagle Tad is hand raised. Let's hear from him. Then we'll move on to Adriana.
We have two more expressions to learn today still. Everyone.
Okay. Hello, Eagle.
Hello, Dr. Drew. Hello, Adri. Great to see you again.
Good to see you or hear from you.
thank you. Yeah, talk about the wind. I mean, you know, when my daughter graduated from high school, we wanted to and took her on the our wing. You know, I mean, a lot. It's not only financial supporting, and also we wanted to give her some advice about her career. I mean, and you know, and we like which college was bad for her, and which career will benefit for her life. But I think and the financial support was necessary is very important. And the advice for her career, it didn't work, you know. I mean, the children, they want to something, they want to have their own ideas.
Definitely.
They want to go to some college, they like to go, not from our advice. Yeah.
So you were, you said you tried to give your child financial support and guidance, you know, advice. Yeah. But maybe they don't always take the advice.
Yeah.
That's true around the world.
Very loud motor outside my window. I'm sorry, everybody. Yeah, and actually, Fariba in the chat said that she has a similar expression in her language, which I believe is Persian, right? Mm-hmm. I think she's from Iran. She says, we have the same idiom in our language, to take someone under the wings and feathers. It means to support someone financially and emotionally. Yeah, so you can use this expression in the same way.
Okay, and I'm sure that your daughter turned out pretty well, right, Beagle?
Yeah, exactly. And she goes to the medical school. And now she graduated. And she goes to the, and also want to be a physician.
A physician?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
Well, I'm sure she's made you proud.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Yes.
Okay, so we have a new person with their hand up, Eleonora.
Hello.
Can we hear from you? Hello.
Hello.
Can you hear me?
Yes. Oh, like your good. The image is very funny.
A cat with hot dogs.
Thank you. Yeah. Well, to begin with, I would like to say that I'm a student and I'm going to pass my final exams next year. And in fact, I felt pretty nervous about them because I had huge problems with Russian history. But hopefully I found a good tutor and she took me under her wing. She explained to me how easily memorize dates and historical figures. She taught me how to write historical essays, and now I don't have any problems with it, thanks to her.
Wonderful. Wow.
Amazing. Please teach us how to do all of that as well.
Yes.
So you used a good word that is connected to this expression in some ways. A tutor is someone who helps a student or someone else with an educational field or topic, one-on-one usually. So,
yes.
Yeah, it's very, very beneficial for sure.
Okay.
Well, good luck. So did you take the exam already or are you still preparing?
No, I'm still preparing and I have a year to be ready for them.
Wow. Well, so in fact, it seems like you are getting all your ducks in a row.
Oh, shall we show that expression?
That's the next expression. Thank you for that.
That's an interesting expression.
Thank you.
I should take it down.
Yes. Well, we will be moving on to that one. But thank you for joining us and thank you for sharing your story.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Bye. All right. So, here we go.
So one more slide over.
There you go.
So this is our next bird related idiom. As we learned before, a duck is a kind of bird that swims in a pond or lake. So to get all your ducks in a row means to get prepared and organized for something that is going to happen. So this one, I think you can imagine a mother duck, again, with all of her little ducks called ducklings, walking in a very orderly way behind her. So row is, row means like a straight line. So that is where this expression comes from.
And I think we could go back to the animal world again for when we talk about the young have certain things that are programmed into their mind already.
Yeah. Leading, so, right, following their
the baby,
parents.
Yeah, the ducklings follow the mother. Uh-huh. I saw a funny video actually on Instagram yesterday. A policeman who was walking in a park in Texas, and he was helping some ducklings find their mother. They had gotten lost, and so all the ducklings were following the policeman in a row. So funny.
So cute. Well, and they're one of my favorite games as a child was Are You My Mother? Oh. And it has a duck, a mama duck with a little some babies, and the you have to find the one that is magnetic that will connect to the the mother, the bigger duck. Am I making this up or is this an actual game?
I heard that there's a book, Are You My Mother?
This was a board game that I had, yes, I think. So,
shall we go to the next slide?
Yeah, so I guess we explained that pretty well. A lot of us were trying to get all of our, or all our ducks in a row before the stay-at-home orders took effect. So by that I mean buying important household items like toilet paper, maybe buying a huge bag of rice, making sure you were prepared, I guess, to...
Do you remember when we had a staff meeting, one of our last staff meetings in the building? I was telling people, you should have enough food for 1 month.
Yeah.
And
I think back then people thought that was a little extreme, but it has been over a month now. So, yeah.
And I bought my toilet paper before the stores sold out.
So did I. I did not get a big enough bag of rice, however, so.
Oh, I have extra rice if you need some.
Oh, thank you.
I'll take you under my wing.
Yes. Dr. Jill takes everyone under her wing, that's for sure.
Here's our question then.
Yeah. Were you able to get all your ducks in a row before stay-at-home orders took effect where you live? And you can explain what you wish you could have better prepared for.
Let's see, we have Katerina, and then we'll hear from Adriana. Hello, Katerina.
Hello. How are you?
All right. Yeah, we see your picture.
You? Yeah, it's me. actually, I couldn't get... Wait. All the ducks in a row.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, am I right?
Mm-hmm. Yes. So you could not, you were not able to get all your ducks in a row in time.
Yeah, I, because I was in another city with my family. Mm-hmm. So when we came back to our home, there was a stay-at-home order. So we couldn't prepare for it properly, but we can go out to buy food and what we need. So I don't think it is a big problem. But I wish we could prepare more properly.
Yeah. Yeah, I think some places maybe provided a little advanced notice or warnings that things, that stay-at-home orders were going to be put in place, and others had no warning. So they had no chance, the citizens are had no chance of getting all their ducks in a row ahead of time. Yeah,
I think it would be bad if someone is in another country and they can't go back to their country. And I think it's very awful.
Yeah,
if you
definitely
stay
stuck somewhere. Yeah,
somewhere else. It's bad.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad you were able to get back with your family. That's at least
Yes, that's important. Glad yeah. too.
Yeah. Thank you for joining us again.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yay. And Adriana has her hand up here. Hello, Adriana.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Fine. You know, I got first I lock at home, and after that, I got all ducks in a row because I called the supermarket, and they brought me all the things I need. I need it.
Okay, good.
Yeah. And the other thing I want to say is that in quarantine, before also, but in this difficult times of quarantine, God has taken me under his wing, and I feel protected. I feel he cares for me. He gives me joy. Well, it's wonderful because I feel well.
That's great. Yeah.
Even if I live alone, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is a good. Wonderful. Yeah, thank you. People do
and
use this expression. It can be used in a religious way as well. It's many meanings.
Mm-hmm. you actually gave me the opportunity to join this because you said that one Saturday in a podcast. So,
yeah.
Because if you haven't said that, I wouldn't have joined this because I always hear you by podcasts.
Oh. Thank you. Yeah, you gave us.
I entered the page, but when I entered the page, I look for something special. For instance, I look for Ask a Teacher. I look for Words and Their Stories, right? So,
okay.
Or some article that I don't know the words.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, thank you.
I don't know the words.
Your email explaining how you heard about the program on the podcast has encouraged us to include that kind of little promotion in more of our podcasts, because I do think people we forget like how many people might be listening, so it's
because you know it's easier in podcasts it's very easy because we put the podcast and we, for instance, the iPhone is playing that and we have breakfast and whatever.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I have been listening to a lot of podcasts lately, for sure.
I can imagine.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much. And we are glad. We're glad you got all your ducks in a row.
And that you don't feel alone, too.
Yes.
For sure. No, I don't.
As Abraham said, we're all in this together.
Yep.
Yeah, also.
Thank you.
We have Tang Nung Ho Pham, I think. Who? Let's see here. Had their hand up. There we go. Unmute. Hello. Oh,
hello, Dr. Chu. Hello, Miss Ashley Thompson.
Can you how are tell you? Us tell us what name you like to be called?
Ngom. Ngom. Tan
Ngom.
Ngom.
Tan Ngom. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, that's right. Well, it's very interesting. First of all, I want to say that all members in this meeting are under your wings in learning English.
That was a very good good example, and thank you.
me, I am under Miss Ashley Thompson's wings for many years. I listened to learning VOA learning English for many years.
Awesome. Already. Thank you. Your English is very good. So
I am a teacher.
Oh, okay.
I am a teacher. Do you the Hua Wing with the dog? I'm just speaking for you a few minutes ago.
Yes?
He's my student.
Oh, aren't you proud of him?
There are some my students. I teach math, and there are some my students and some and my daughter. Really, I have to encourage them to raise their hands and speaking. And mm-hmm. it's very funny that a few minutes ago, my daughter, she understands the idiom under wing, mm-hmm. and she raised her hand, and then turned to another idiom, and she cannot understand, and she asked me, and I tried to chat with her, I tried to explain, and encourage her to raise her hand again, but it's a. But she hesitates and she does not dare to raise her hand.
Okay.
Well, I have been teaching for 19 years.
Oh, wow.
I teach the 12 grade. The 12 grade. So, and I think that in the Thai lockdown like this, I also use Zoom to teach that. And so, I understand that before you can give us the lesson like this, we have to prepare a lot.
You have to prepare a lot. Yeah.
Yes,
excellent. Who is your daughter?
Elizabeth. Elizabeth.
All making sense. Okay.
Oh yes, we talked to Elizabeth. Yes.
She said that about the naughty cat.
Yes, we learned about the naughty cat yesterday. Yeah.
For many years teaching, I hope that I can share you some experience. Mm-hmm. A class in Vietnam, there are about 40 students in the class.
It's pretty 40. Big, yeah.
Yeah, it's very big. And to some students, you can give them the guides, you can tell them how to do. You can do something and they imitate in math in some kind of ways. But to some students, you cannot tell them. You just give them some tips, small tips, some suggestions, and they can find their own answers.
Find their own way.
Yes, that's right. Some students, you have to be strong emotion. And to some students, you have to be with a very soft emotion. Yes, that's right.
Yes, for sure. There's a lot of psychology involved in teaching as well.
Yeah.
Yes, I agree. Yes, I'm grateful to you for many years of listening.
All right. Well,
thank you so much for telling
your students about us too.
Yes. And thank you for explaining how everyone is connected and related.
I am sure that I will encourage my daughter and my students to raise their hands and speaking to all of you. Maybe I tell them that they don't need to understand the question. You can ask the teachers.
Can you repeat, please? Or please explain in a different way. Yeah.
Be more confident. Yes. For another members for their turns. Yes.
Thank you so much.
It's good hearing from you. And you know, you are underscoring the idea that Yasmin mentioned the other day. I see she's got her hand up. We'll get to you after Yas. Yasmin was saying, I feel like you're part of my family.
Yes, okay. Great. Yes, I agree with that. Yes. To encourage our children, our students, encourage that I understand that both of you are very patient to listen, try to understand. Our awful nation.
Awesome. Thank you.
Okay. Talk to you later.
Thank you so much.
Bye. Okay, so I see iPhone 3, I see your hand is raised. You'll be after Yas, and then we'll get to Yasmin too. Hello.
Hello. Hi, I'm Michelle. I'm Mexican. Oh. And I'm very happy to be here with us.
Thank you for joining us.
Sorry?
Oh, I said thank you for joining our lesson today.
Yeah. In fact, I can understand some things you are talking. Very some things. But in fact, I have practiced English since I was 10 years, but it's difficult for me now, because I don't practice a fluent conversation. Only I study the grammar or the vocabulary or many things, right things, or but I don't practice the listening or the speaking and more. But I want to know. I want to stay to be in other situations with us. I like so much this.
Great. So you want to find more chances to practice speaking and listening?
Sorry?
Dr. Jill, maybe your connection is clearer than
yeah. So you're now beginning to practice again.
Exactly.
And this and using the internet is a good way now that we all have to stay at home. Where are you in Mexico, may I ask?
Yeah, Mexico, Puebla.
Uh-huh. Puebla.
Uh-huh. Okay. We have Claudia in Mexico too, who joins us often.
Oh yeah.
Have you seen Claudia? Yeah. She shared her cat and her dogs with us yesterday. and do you have birds there? I think I hear birds.
My birdie?
I hear birds outside.
I'm outside to my home because my parents is sleeping and it's rarely for
it's earlier there than where we are.
Yeah
well thank you so much, and please keep practicing with us. Okay.
Yeah, thank you so
you.
Good to meet you.
Good nice to meet you. Nice too. To meet you.
Okay. We had let's see where it was our friend with there we go. Hello.
Hello.
Tell us your name and where you are.
Hi, teachers. My name is Thuy from Vietnam. I'm in Hanoi now.
Okay.
Thuy.
And I often hear VOA special English, and I like it very much. Great. And you know, I got all the duck in a row. Mm-hmm. Before the social standing.
Uh-huh. Social distancing?
Distancing, yes. Uh-huh. Social distancing. And I prepare very very good. And in the future, I want to get on the duck in a row because I prepare to go to Canada. Oh, and I want to talk to my daughter and my and her friend in English, and I want to practice English every day.
Oh, good.
And
those are some good goals.
Yes, yeah. I have a first time to join this video call, a video conversation, and I hope in the future every day I will enjoy and practice English. Because I want to improve my listening and speaking. Mm-hmm. And I want to stand under the wings in learning English.
Oh, great.
Right?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
We'll keep you under our wings.
Okay, thank you.
We will be here for you every day.
Thank you. And I try to join the conversation every day, every evening in this time in Vietnam.
Yes.
So where does your daughter live in Canada?
Oh, she lives in Calgary.
Calgary. Oh, that's such a beautiful place.
Oh, very beautiful. I have been there.
Oh. It has mountains. It's the Rocky Mountains.
Yes,
Canada.
Rocky Mountain is the view is very beautiful, great.
Mm-hmm. But cold, much colder than Vietnam.
Yes. Very cold.
Oh, it gets so snow. Cold up there. Yeah.
So you'll have to learn how to ski.
Oh no, I haven't tried. Yes,
you can learn though.
Yes, I think so.
Or what I did, I used to live near the mountains in California and also in Japan, and I tried snowboarding one time, and I did downhill skiing maybe one or two times, but I really enjoy the cross-country skis. So this is where you just go on a flat place, mostly flat. Your skis go back and forth. It's much slower and easier than going downhill.
I wish maybe in the future.
Yeah.
I try it.
Okay.
You don't have
I will try it.
Or at least go watch.
Yes.
All right. Thanks for joining us, Thuy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You again soon.
Thank you.
Okay. Yas is waving too. Let's see. We haven't heard from Yasmin yet. And maybe
hello, Dr. Jen. Hello, Ashley.
Hello.
Welcome to the family show.
Yeah. It's really right. Okay, my son's birthday was at the beginning of the month. Uh-huh. So I got all my ducks in a row to prepare for the party at home because of the quarantine. So I made a cake at home, decorate home, and ready for the party.
Oh, that's your son is very lucky.
Yeah.
You seem very well organized. It takes to try to.
How old is your son?
He is 9 years old.
Oh. Did he have a good birthday?
Yeah, he enjoyed it very much.
Excellent.
It's hard to do birthdays in quarantine.
Yes, it's very. So we made it at home as a family, only me and his father and his sister only.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, my sister's birthday was on Monday, and it was also very difficult. Her husband tried to make her a cake, but he's usually very good at baking. He bakes bread and all sorts of good things, but they did not have enough of something, so he used milk instead. I don't know. And it was so bad. The cake was so disgusting. They could not eat it because they did not have the right ingredients because he did not get all his ducks in a row.
Yeah.
Yes.
Anyway.
Thank you.
It sounds like you're a great planner. Yes.
Good, yeah. Yes. Thank God.
Okay, next we're going to hear from
thank you.
Roberta in Brazil.
Hi. Hello.
Hello again. Hi.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Must be
guys.
Very, very early there, is it?
No. It's 9 o'clock. It's 10 o'clock.
Oh, it's later than our. Okay.
Yes. What time is in there now?
9 o'clock.
9 o'clock. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So, have you gotten your ducks in a row for something?
Well, and we've been locked down for 3 weeks, and in the week that they said that we're gonna have it, so I tried to buy everything I needed because it's not good to get out all the time, and we can't get out. And if we get out, we have to use masks. So I don't really like to use the masks. So got everything I need, all my ducks in a row, and then I'm safe here at home.
Good. Yeah. Seems like a lot of us were able to get our ducks in a row. Some of us not so much, but I think people who maybe did not take it as seriously as others may not have gotten their ducks in a row and are now kind of regretting that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But like some people here in Brazil, they're not taking it serious. They think it's a joke.
Oh,
you know, maybe I think it's everywhere. They think, oh, is that so big? Like they are saying, you know, I don't know. I think some people, they're not taking it serious. So they didn't get their ducks in a row, you know?
Yeah. Well, hopefully the message spreads more to take.
Yeah. And how is in there? Like, is lockdown too there?
Oh, yeah.
I would guess, but I have spoken with friends in other countries and it's much more strict where they live. For example, like we have hardware stores are still open, bicycle stores are still open. Certain types of businesses have remained open that are closed in a lot of other places, I have learned. So
like squares and everything's are open, like beaches and
No. Beaches are mostly closed now. Yeah. And national parks are also, it depends on each state. So each state
and
county, everything has like different rules.
Just yesterday, the subway system in our area said they would require people to wear a mask on the subway.
That's important.
Many subway stops have closed because not enough people are going to them.
I got you.
And the federal government of workers are mostly staying home. I think a lot of people are working from home here now.
Yeah, here in Brazil too. The service that you can work from home, they're working from home.
Yeah.
You know,
well, like I see. Speaking of the time, we've gone past our ending time again.
That's true.
But it's so enjoyable talking to everyone.
Yeah, thank you so much, Roberta.
And we had one more question, Ashley. Maybe we can let people think about this one for another time. Maybe they can actually send us an email. What are some bird-related idioms in your native language?
Yeah, we didn't even get to our third expression. We had so many fun conversations with everyone today. So that's what's most important, is to practice speaking.
Uh-huh. And actually, you know, should we tell everybody our email in case they want to send us a question
or the learning English
they'd
email.
Like to see.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll put it in our chat box here. And maybe you could tell them while I'm typing it.
Yeah, you can email us at, I think it's learningenglish@voanews.com.
Yeah.
And you can also, of course, find us on Facebook and Instagram. And someone else asked for the podcast link.
Oh, okay.
Dr. Jill can find that.
I sure can.
And you can also find it in the podcast store. It's obviously free. And thank you, everybody. Yes, so tomorrow we will be discussing how introverts and extroverts are experiencing the quarantine period differently.
With one of our biggest extroverts in the office.
So extrovert is someone who likes to be around people all the time. And that is Katie Weaver.
Yes.
So you will have fun with that. And Dr. Jill, you're an introvert, right? Or are you kind of both?
I feel like becoming a teacher made me less introverted.
Yes. Definitely.
We can talk about that tomorrow.
Yeah. Okay. Well, thank you, everyone. Thanks. See you tomorrow. Bye.